In this learning module, we will consider the ways in which Spotfire summary tables may be used to visualize data, as this is one of the options available to display values which represent an aggregate view of the underlying data table. While this visualization type is relatively easy to configure, it does have the limitation that marking and coloring are not possible in the summary table. Summary tables can be configured to present aggregate views of an entire column from the underlying data table. Here we have a sum, average, and maximum value from the total amount of purchases column. Alternatively, a summary table may be configured to group data based upon categorical values which exist in another column. For example, here, store location has been selected as the categorization variable. Consequently, the summary table reports aggregate values for each major store location value. Keep in mind that regardless of which of these configuration options is selected for the summary table, no color can be added to this visualization type, and the visualization does not allow marking. Let's open an example Spotfire analysis file, which has been configured with several summary table examples. Use Open File and navigate to the example with Interpreting Summary Tables in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. The summary tables, which have been configured in this analysis document, aggregate values from this underlying data table, which relates information from a MegaMart chain of department stores. On this page, three summary tables have been configured. This summary table displays statistical measures like sums, averages, standard deviations, medians, maximum values, 90th percentile values, and interquartile ranges for each of the departmental purchase columns. Note that with the data in its currently unfiltered state, these aggregate values reflect all of the data in each column. This summary table, on the other hand, has been configured to group values by store location, which has been assigned as a categorization variable. So, for each of the departmental columns, sums are displayed for each of the major store locations. The columns displayed in this summary table may be sorted by clicking on any of the statistical measure headings. One click sorts lowest to highest, a second sorts highest to lowest, and a third click returns the original sort order. Clicking on the statistical measure in this summary table sorts the values within each column. Consequently, only the order of the categorization values is sorted, not the columns themselves. The final summary table on this page has been configured to relate the difference between the count aggregation method and the unique count aggregation method. If, for example, you wanted to know how many stores are there in the underlying data table, you would want to view a unique count of those values. In this data table, there are 84 stores. The count, on the other hand, indicates how many rows of data have values. Because there are no empty store number values, and there are 754 rows of data in the underlying data table, 754 is the value displayed for the count aggregation. It is the fact that the same store number values are repeated on multiple rows that makes the unique count value a different result. Even though marking is not possible in any of these summary tables, filters may be used to limit the data from the underlying data table which contributes to these aggregate values. So, as we limit the data to display only increasingly younger maximum age limits, or remove female customers from the visualizations, the calculations adjust accordingly.